An elected international director of Toastmasters International. Our speaker has learned some differences between the books and her experiences. Let's listen to why you want to consider joining a board of directors too. Take it away, Carol.
Thank you, Jim. What a pleasure. You probably are saying to yourself, I do not want to be on the board of directors. I have no idea what it means, but it sounds like work and responsibility. And some of you are going to be saying things like, I have too much time to do other things. I need to do other things, and it's pressing on my brain and my time, and I want to instead be drinking beers with my friends, enjoying the beautiful sunset. That's what I'd rather be doing. And I can think of many things that we might say I would rather be doing. But let me explain why you want to be on the board of directors somewhere to learn some new skills. The first thing is it gives you an opportunity to be creative. We have some really creative folks on this listening in session, and I know you want to have new avenues for your creativity. The second thing is this allows us to be strategic in nature. We go from idea to planning to action. We can actually implement this. Well, sometimes it takes more than our term, but we can implement it. Third, we get to work with an awesome team. Look at these great people, and we get to work together, and they really are great people. I love it. But we do have to be vigilant for groupthink. We don't want to think like everybody else. We don't want to just nod our heads. We have to be independent thinkers to be able to express our opinions and then come back and say, I agree. Or I disagree. That's our job. So let's actually talk about our job. Our job is to protect and represent shareholder interests. If it's not a public institution, then we have to protect and represent the interests of the owners. We are to provide checks and balances with layers of judgment and protection. So we have to have judgment. It's okay. And third, we want to establish a shared sense of institutional purpose. We need to know what our purpose is. We need to implement it. We need to go forward and say, I love this organization because of what it represents. We have a number of objectives. The first thing is we must be in charge, in some respects, of the management team. We're not implementing and being the management team. We are simply selecting, encouraging, advising, and evaluating and compensating our management team, such as the CEO. Our job is also to approve the strategy and the direction in which our management proposes to take the company. They may propose something, or we can propose something to them for them to implement. We need to monitor performance and the way in which the management operates the corporate business. And we need to stay focused on our policies, the articles of incorporation, to ensure that we are not in violation of those policies. Now, there are many different types of boards, and they have changed significantly over the time. As we look in the history, our history has transformed it, especially around the year 2001, 2003. Some of you may remember a couple organizations that really struggled with ethics. And our laws, particularly in the United States, but in many parts of the world, transformed because of it. Now, different types of boards could include public versus private, small, medium, or large. Large could be greater than 11 people on the board. It could be statutory or advisory. You don't make a lot of money. Don't expect it. I'm on a volunteer board. There are some boards, though, that will be sizable in the payment. I say sizable. It's considered a part-time job. All right, I talked about this already, but your board sizes will vary. Ours is one of the larger ones. All right, there are a number of committees that you must be involved with. It's not just going to board meetings. Our committee work includes things such as the finance committee. Almost everybody, every board has you on that finance committee. There's the compensation committee, which I mentioned earlier with the CEO compensation. We have nominating and guidance committees. Such as with our, in this organization, with our region advisors, but most organizations are looking at who do we nominate to be the next CEO. We typically will have 6 to 10 meetings per year in the committee work, along with the convention, along with our regular board meetings. can be sizable, as I mentioned. The meetings may last for 157 hours per year, and that's on average what people have said. Oh my gosh, you said if you didn't have time, you'd rather be drinking the beer. I know that, but where else could you get this opportunity to be creative, strategic, and have such great team to be involved with? I want to encourage you to reach out and try this. This was something that I underestimated, not just on time. Yes, I am investing a lot of time in it, but in terms of what I would get from it. I'm very much enjoying the camaraderie amongst the board. I love the decisions that we're involved with and that we're making at the strategic level. So sign on up. Look forward to hearing from you. Cheers.
Thank you, Carol.